It was the stuff of nightmares. All 230 people aboard TWA Flight 800 died when the plane went down in flames in the Atlantic Ocean minutes after takeoff from New York's JFK Airport. The year was 1996. After an exhaustive four-year investigation, which included the dredging of the ocean to piece together more than 95% of the aircraft, the National Transportation Safety Board said the cause of the crash was a spark from bad wiring, one that set off the fuel tank. But now, almost two decades later, six retired members of the investigative team are changing their story. It's all the center of a new documentary, TWA Flight 800, that makes the claim that the fuel tank theory is bogus and that an explosion outside the plane brought the plane down.
Primary conclusion was the explosive forces came from outside the airplane, not the center fuel tank.
Would that statement have been in your analysis?
If I got the right one.
The agenda was that this is an accident, make it so.
But not so fast. Former FBI Assistant Director James Kallstrom, who headed up the criminal probe after the crash, he joins me now with his side of this painful story. Mr. Kallstrom, thank you so much for joining us. The documentary claims an explosion outside the plane caused the crash, and the true cause was covered up by the government. 17 years later, what is your reaction to this documentary?
It's not true, Jake. You know, we had an exhausted investigation. I had 1,000 agents assigned at the peak. And we took very seriously the idea that a missile could have shot down the plane. You know, 747s don't blow up in fireballs that can be seen 40 miles away. Yeah, we were at a very high state of alert in the United States during that period of time. So the chances were, I mean, we didn't know for sure, we had no idea, but it could have been terrorism. It could have been the intervention of some maniac at that airport, either by bringing aboard a plane, putting a bomb on the plane in the luggage or in the stowage areas, or some mechanic putting something somewhere, or a missile being shot at the plane. We used all the assets of the United States, all the missile experts in the military. We shot missiles at planes so we could study, you know, what kind of damage they did to the aluminum frames. FBI agents are great at looking at bombs because we look at a lot of bombs. But we weren't great at looking at missile damage, so we built up a reservoir of that detail. We recovered 97% of the airplane from the ocean. Over the hoots and cries of many in the Congress and politicians and elsewhere, why is the FBI still in this investigation? And the answer is the FBI investigates Title 18 crimes, crime aboard American flag-carrying aircraft being one of them. And so it was our responsibility to find out, was this an act of terrorism? And we couldn't do that till we had most of the airplane, which took us a long, long time. We ended up with about 97% of it. After dredging, after going to the White House twice to get permission to keep spending money to do this thing. So I'm very, very confident that we had enough of that airplane to make the judgment that no criminal intervention, to our knowledge at the time, our knowledge in 1996, wherever that science was, that did not bring down the aircraft. Now, the NTSB, separate organization that does the civilian end of these investigations, mechanical, you know, electrical, pilot error, those things, they drew the conclusion of the center fuel tank exploding.
Sir, do you have any explanation as to why these former investigators, now retired, seem to be suggesting that there was a cover-up, they were directed to say that this was an accident when they thought that the explosion came from outside the plane? Do you have any idea? Have you talked to any of them?
Not to my knowledge. I think it's preposterous, quite frankly, Jake. You know, I understand now, just in the little bit I read in the paper, that they're retired. You know, if they felt that way back then, they could have come to me. I was someone desiring to get to the bottom of this thing, believe me. And I had a reputation for not pussyfooting around. Yet it seems like they've comfortably waited till they have their pensions before they became whistleblowers. So I think it's a bunch of bullcrap. I don't really understand that. If they felt that strongly. And I don't, for knowing the people at NTSB and the science that they brought to it, you know, for them to disregard something that was important or correct, I just don't see that that's possible. I have no idea why they came forward now, other than the fact maybe it's a good time for, you know, this idea of blowing whistles and making documentaries.
In 1996, ABC reporter Pierre Salinger, a former spokesman for President John F. Kennedy, said he had a government document saying that Navy gunners accidentally shot down the airplane while conducting missile tests. What was your response to that?
I'm being kind when I tell you that he was out of his mind. Here's a guy who worked for JFK. Here's a guy who did a time in the Senate as a senator of the United States of America. You know, over in Cannes with probably too many drinks in him, waving a piece of paper around saying it's a report from French intelligence that the USS Normandy, a proud cruiser of the American fleet, you know, with 450 patriots aboard, shot down this commercial airplane. You know, it was just preposterous. It was the rantings of some wacko on the internet. There was not a report from French intelligence. But nevertheless, we went forward. I called the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, actually prior to that, and we looked at every military asset in the area. We interviewed every member of the USS Normandy. By the way, they were out of range of TWA Flight 100 by about 200 miles. But it's just a preposterous thing to say. And it hurts the families. I mean, that's the thing that irritates me about this thing now coming forward. You know, it's basically BS, in my view. And the families have to go through this whole thing. And we were tight with the families, and we were emotional friends and connected with them all the way into this thing. So I think it's basically terrible.
The NTSB released a statement this morning about the demand being made by the filmmakers to reopen the case. Quote, while the NTSB rarely reinvestigates issues that have already been examined, our investigations are never closed, and we can review any new information not previously considered by the board. It seems to be saying, the NTSB, that they're open to taking another look. I'm not sure why they would say that if so much time and expense was already made to investigate it. What would your reaction be to it being opened up again?
Well, if they have some evidence that's credible, I don't know what it could be. This fellow's a physicist, but he's an armchair physicist. You know, I don't know any of his ability. He didn't see the plane. He wasn't working there. The FBI is in the same position. We'd reopen the case also. That plane, Jake, is in a hangar in Virginia. It's been in a hangar either in New York or Virginia all this time. There it is. There's all the pieces. You know, bring your best scientist. We've had the best we could find. MIT, all around the world, look at this. Metallurgists, we hired the head metallurgist, retired from Alcoa. We had our own metallurgists look at this thing. You know, this is not something that was done in haste. It was done after about a year and a half of thorough, thorough investigation.
All right, James Kallstrom, former assistant director of the FBI, thank you so much for talking to us today, and good luck to you in retirement.
My pleasure. Thank you.